Good morning to everyone. I am M. Sweetling Sonia, Assistant Professor from Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Now I am going to present the topic PN junction diode. So two of the most widely known semiconductor devices that are commonly in use are junction diodes and transistors. So both of which come under the common category called solid state devices. So solid state device is nothing but an electronic device which can be operated only by the movement of electrons in a solid piece of semiconductor material. So it's important to know about semiconductor. So what is a semiconductor? It is a material whose resistivity property lies below these conductors, whereas it is more than that of an insulator. Also, the conductivity property is more than that of an insulator but less than that of the conductors. So this is most preferably used for all type of electronic devices. So semiconductor, from the name itself it says, it semiconducts a current. So the commonly used semiconductor materials are silicon, germanium and gallium arsenide materials. So we have two types of semiconductor. One is intrinsic semiconductor and the other is extrinsic semiconductor. So intrinsic semiconductor is a pure form of semiconductor. So here the common examples of intrinsic semiconductors are pure form of germanium and silicon semiconductor materials. So in intrinsic semiconductor material, as no impurities are added, the number of positive charges and the number of negative charges are equal. In the next type, that is extrinsic type of semiconductor, it is an impure form of semiconductor. The semiconductors are made impure by the process of doping. So doping is nothing but the process of adding impurities to the pure form of semiconductor. So based on the type of impurities added, it can be classified into two types. One is N-type semiconductor and the other is P-type semiconductor. So N-type semiconductor is obtained by doping the pure semiconductor with a pentavalent impurities. Some common pentavalent impurities added are phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. So in this figure, the figure shows a silicon crystal structure in which a silicon atom is replaced by a pentavalent impurity, that is phosphorus. So this results in the release of an extra free electron. So in N-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers will be electrons. So next one is P-type semiconductor. The P-type semiconductor is obtained by doping the pure semiconductor with some trivalent impurities. So example for trivalent impurities are boron, aluminium, indium and gallium. So in that figure, in the silicon crystal structure, the silicon atom is replaced by a pentavalent impurity, that is boron atom. So the boron atom causes a release of an extra hole. So in the P-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers will be holes. So now let us move to the topic PN junction diode. So how will you obtain a PN junction diode? This PN junction diode is nothing but a two-terminal semiconductor device that is obtained by joining a P-type semiconductor material and an N-type semiconductor material that is separated by a small junction called depletion region. So in PN junction diode, it consists of two electrodes. One is positive electrode, that is called as anode, and the negative electrode, that is called as cathode. So in P-type semiconductor material, the majority charge carriers are holes, and in the N-type semiconductor material, the majority charge carriers are electrons. So the real component appearance is shown in the second diagram. So this is the electronic symbol of a PN junction diode. So we all know the PN junction diode allows a current flow in a single direction. So the direction of current flow is indicated by the symbol of a triangle. So the diode can be made operated only under proper biasing condition. So what is meant by biasing? So biasing is nothing but applying a proper external voltage so as to activate or operate the diode. So first, zero bias condition, that is no biasing is applied or no external supply is applied. So under zero bias condition, how the diode operates? So under zero bias condition, the majority charge carriers, that is electrons in the N-type material, cross a junction and combine with the holes in the P-type semiconductor material. Similarly, the holes in the P-type material cross a junction and combine with the electrons in the N-type semiconductor material. So at one point, this migration stops. At that time, the stopping of migration is due to the fact that the electrons in the N-type semiconductor material are repelled by the negative charge of the P-type semiconductor material, Similarly, the holes in the p-type material are started repelled by the holes in the n-type net positive charge of this n-type semiconductor material. The result, net result of this is the formation of the depletion region or the space charge region. The region is called as depletion region because this region is depleted of free charge carriers, or this region contains only immobile ions. The thickness of this depletion region is very small, it's in the range of micrometer. The depletion region causes an electric field to establish near the junction. So the electric field acts as a barrier for further migration of the charge carriers to diffuse the junction. So the resulting potential is called as a potential barrier, which is very small for that is 0.3 volt for germanium type semiconductor and is 0.7 volt for the silicon type of semiconductor. So diode can be operated in two biasing conditions, one is forward bias and the other one is reverse bias. So first one is forward bias. So what is forward bias? Connecting the positive terminal of the battery to the p-type semiconductor material and negative terminal of the battery to the n-type semiconductor material. So by forward biasing the p-n junction diode, what happens? The holes in the p-type semiconductor material are attracted towards the negative terminal of the battery, and the electrons in the n-type semiconductor material are attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery. So due to which what happens? So the depletion region near the junction is reduced. So at one point, the electric field is exerted near the junction, which is in the direction opposite to the direction of the potential barrier. When the applied forward voltage is increased beyond the potential barrier, then the junction, the depletion region disappears and the barrier is completely eliminated, and the junction resistance is completely reduced to 0 ohm, due to which the current starts flowing in the diode. This current is called as forward current. So next one is reverse bias. Reverse bias condition means connecting the negative terminal of the battery to the p-type semiconductor material and the positive terminal of the battery to the n-type semiconductor material. So by reverse biasing the p-n junction diode, what happens? The holes in the p-type semiconductor material will be attracted towards the negative terminal of the battery, and electrons in the n-type semiconductor material will be attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery. So this widens the depletion region. Now also an electric field is established near the junction of the p-n junction diode. So the direction of this electric field generated is in the same direction as that of the potential barrier. So due to which the width of the depletion region is widened. So the resistance near the junction is very high. So this resists the flow of current. But practically, a small amount of current flows in the diode, that is due to the minority charge carriers. And this current is called as reverse leakage current or reverse saturation current. So when we keep on increasing the reverse voltage, what happens? The electric field generator exerts a force on the electrons, thereby releasing them from the covalent bond. And this results in the junction breakdown. So this effect is said to be the avalanche effect. This results in the damage of the diode. So next is the VI characteristics of p-n junction diode. So what is VI characteristics? That shows the relation between the voltage and current, and it also shows the operating region of any device. So first one, under forward bias condition, when we keep on increasing the voltage, there is no current flow until the applied voltage reaches the barrier potential. So once the applied voltage or forward voltage reaches the barrier potential, there is a linear increase in the current flow. So that point is called as knee point. So if the diode used is made of silicon material, then the knee point is 0.7 volt. And if the diode used is made of germanium semiconductor material, the knee point is 0.3 volt. So this is the VI characteristics under reverse bias condition. So that is drawn between reverse voltage and reverse current. Under reverse bias condition, when we increase the reverse voltage, there is small amount or no current flows in the diode, and the current that is flowing in the diode due to minority charge carriers, which is called as reverse saturation current. And at particular point, when the voltage is increased to a breakdown voltage, there is a sharp increase in the current flow, and that results in the junction breakdown. And this is said to be avalanche breakdown or avalanche effect. Next is the advantages of p-n junction diode. There is no heating or warm up time for any for a p-n junction diode. That the speed of operation is very fast. So the cost is very cheap compared to vacuum tube. So the cost is also less than 10 rupees, and it does not operate unless a proper biasing condition is applied. Then it is operated at a very low voltage, that is 0.7 volt for silicon diode and 0.3 volt for germanium diode. Hence the power consumption is also very low. The size is smaller and the weight is light, therefore it occupies very less space. The life is also longer, that is lifetime rating is 25,000 to 50,000 hours. Next is the application of p-n junction diode. So the main application of p-n junction diode is in rectifier circuit. So rectifier circuit is an electronic circuit that converts alternating current to direct current. It is of two types, one is half wave and full wave, and the other is full wave rectifier. In full wave rectifier, both the cycles will be converted to the direct current, whereas in half wave rectifier, single cycle is converted to the direct current. In both rectifiers, p-n junction diodes are used. So next one is as switch. So when the diode is in forward bias condition, then the diode will be used as a closed switch. When the diode is in reverse bias condition, the diode will be used as an open switch. So diodes can also be used as light emitting diode for emitting different types of colors. So diodes can also be used in wave shaping circuits like clipper circuit to clip off the certain portion of the signal without distorting the remaining part of the signal. Next is the summary of the topic. So what is a diode? It is a two-terminal semiconductor device allowing the current flow in one direction, restricting the current flow in the reverse direction. So diode can be operated in both forward bias and reverse bias condition. When the diode is in forward bias condition, the current starts flowing when the applied voltage reaches the knee point, that is 0.7 volt for silicon diode and 0.3 volt for germanium diode. When the diode is operating in the reverse bias condition, no current flows, but practically small amount of current flows, that is due to the minority charge carriers. The current name is reverse saturation current or reverse leakage current. Once the reverse voltage is increased to the breakdown voltage, there is a sharp increase in the current that results in the junction breakdown, and this effect is said to be avalanche effect or avalanche breakdown. This results in the damage of the diode. So the several applications of diodes are in rectifier circuits as LEDs, then a switch, wave shaping circuits like clipping and clamping circuits, and also in protection circuits. So I have listed some of the possible questions that are covered under this topic. So what is a p-n junction diode? Draw the symbol for a p-n junction diode. Then draw the VA characteristics of p-n junction diode. So what is a barrier potential at the junction? So what does mean by reverse saturation current? So list out the advantages of p-n junction diode and what are the applications of p-n junction diode.